But so good. I think we have come very far. This has become a workshop, a seminar, a lecture, a conference. We have heard so much. We have exchanged so much. We have been sensitized so much. But all looks very good. I'm very happy that the communities from the Asal counties or from the pastoralist communities have become the most vocal and most participatory in the national conversation on the BBI. Because no other community has met in the number of events we have met, either as national leaders, as members of parliament, as members of the Frontier Counties Development Council, which brings together the governors from the arid and semi-arid lands, and very many forums. I think we have been able to make our message very clear on where we are, what we think of the BBI, what we want in the BBI, and what our interest is. I'm very happy that our voice is loud and clear. Number two, I think there is a reason why we are so sensitive to a change in the Constitution or any national conversation. And it's a sign that we have come a long way to be where we are. We were the biggest losers in the Lancaster House Conference or the run up to the Kenyan independence. And the debate around the Constitution that time, especially those of us from the Northeast region, we chose a different route from the route Kenyans took that time. We had a bigger ambition, we had a bigger idea, we thought we knew what was good for us, we experimented with some adventure, we went secessionist, we fought our way, we lost that war, and the outcome was decades of marginalization and the underdevelopment and generally remaining in the periphery of the politics and the development of this country. Why we are so sensitive and today we are running around is to ensure that we never go back to where we were that time. And I'm happy that we are holding that debate in the city. Many of you young people travel to Nairobi today by air, by bus, by car. It has never been this good. Those who are slightly older than you, and I'm generally against the guys who spoke here, the young people who want to throw us into the dustbin as old people who should no longer be sitting on the youth. Life was not smooth. We came in the on top of a lorry, which took 12 hours, let's say, Garissa, which was the nearest, to reach here. And it's almost unbelievable to the young people. Last weekend, I took my children through Gitanga Road. And those jacaranda trees there are flowering. And I remember almost more than 40 years ago, maybe in 1977, I passed there very early morning when those trees were still flowering the same way on a lorry which had left 3 p.m., 4 p.m. From Garissa, and we were arriving here 6 in the morning. We were going to Lerana School where we were putting up. And you know, they cannot understand why I was on top of a lorry. I mean, because they have never seen in this age all this present time, somebody traveling on the lorry. So life was tough. The challenges you are facing today have always been there. I don't know whether I would say on a larger scale, we are not this many. The number of people who had opportunities either to come to Nairobi or to go to school were not. But the issues of poverty, lack of school fees, lack of opportunity, lack of employment, lack of access, for each one of you today who is here, maybe who has a university degree, there are 1,000 of your age mates who have never had access to education. simply because the opportunity is not there. So you are a privileged group, a privileged class, and it's the rights and the opportunities for those people which has brought us together to fight for this within these constitutional changes. The young man from Mandera said that we don't want this BBI, or he was opposed to it. Okay, I understand his position, and we don't want a situation where we all think the same. Some people must say maybe he's a university student leader, and they want all solution to all the problems now, sasa na sasa hivi. But I would like to advise you that in fighting for our rights, we must have a little patience, we must have perseverance, but above all, we must have the persistence to pursue the things which are important to us. Everything we have been demanded has been welcomed. Of course, some will take some time to do. Others require some administrative action. But, and we are not foolish, we're able to scrutinize this document and see what our needs are, what has been left out in our, which is in our interest. And there's no way we are going to oppose a document where our views have been welcomed, because we don't want to be left behind. We don't want to lose. The resources being committed to the counties is moving from 15% to 35%. That is a major welcome for our people. Garissa County, for salaries alone, was receiving 13 million shillings. We need to buy more medicine, and we will need. And I know the youth might not be as supportive as maybe we were ourselves. So ladies and gentlemen, I know there are a few questions which have been asked, especially our share of those 70 seats. When we have talked to the principals, we were told that all these stories in the newspapers of how the seats were shared and the fact that we only got one are fake and false stories. That no seats have been shared, no constituents have been created. What this document proposes is some proportional representation method which is based to the number of voters who turn out for an election in a constituency and will be determined after the elections. I hope you get that right. It's not based on the population, it's not based on the number of registered voters, it is based on the number of people who turn up in a constituency and actually who vote. And these seats will be shared after that based on the voter turnout, and it will be managed by political parties. Because it remains illegal in any law, in any country, everywhere in the world, including in Kenya. Therefore, we will ensure that extrajudicial killings come to an end. When it comes to, I know the people from the lake and from the sea will talk about fisheries. Those talks, without that of education, including the presentation by our lawyer and the Honorable Kainan told me that when he wants to retire, meet and to bring out of this conference that we, the ASAL communities, are committed to supporting the BBI in its entirety without any division among ourselves.